Okay, hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning. Your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not an investment advice. So this video is another deep explanation videos of those things which I didn't have explained yet in this ebook. And this time we are talking about the trend channel and the trend lines, which I have talked in the which I have shown you in the previous video where I have traded those trend channel, and I have recognized and noticed that I didn't explain this in deep. So I have to do this video so I can clarify also other things. In the same time, I can say get my ebook. You find the link in the description, and it's for free. It contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, binary option, turbo trading concepts. Yes, and let's see if we are going to show. I can show you how to trade with trend channels. So first of all, I will draw some trend channels so you understand what is going on. For example, the Bollinger Bands are showing you nice trend channels. Yes, if you are applying the one deviation and two deviation like I does. So the trend channel is, for example, this one here. Yes. You see the price is between the one deviation and two deviation, and this is a trend channel. Yes, this is a trend channel. Let me draw this a little bit better here. Today is weekend, and on weekend the market is closed, so I have to show you this on the Bitcoin here. So let me see, this is a trend channel here. Yes, you see here, and it goes, if it's strong, it goes confirm. Yes, it goes confirm with the Bollinger Bands. Yes, one deviation, yes, one deviation and the two deviation Bollinger Band. In between, this is a trend channel, yes, and here we get a breakout. So let me see if I can show you some other trend channel. Yes, here we have another trend channel, yes, and you have to know that if you are using 1 minute expiry time, the trend is not so reliable, so you have to be carefully if you are doing trades in this trend channel. But you see how price acts in this trend, and if it's not moving in this kind of up, yes, if the lines aren't so steepy, yes, it's a ranging market, because I get also questions about ranging market. Ranging market is when price is in a range, yes, so that's the name. And this is, for example, here some kind of ranging market. It's a bad example because this is more a consolidation market, yes. But it looks like this, yes. You have two horizontal lines, and in this horizontal lines, price will move, yes. So let me see, can I remove this? Yes. So this is one here. This is sometimes like ranging, yes. Or you can say this is ranging here. Look at this. This is ranging because price moves in this area here. Yes. Okay. It stopped then. Yes. But this is what a ranging market is. So, okay. Let me do some explanation videos. If you So let me see. So I prepared already this sheet here where I have explained here right how to trade trend channel trading strategy, trend lines and trend line breakout. And when I'm using these arrows, yes, I mean something like this. I don't mean only one candle, because this could be one candle, one green candle, yes, and this could be one red candle, and this is what you have to understand. So if you have, I will do some arrows now, yes, and the uptrend, and I have to copy something else to understand what the trend is about. You have to get to understand this, what I have done here. Let me see. Yes, you have to understand this kind of thing. So let me see. Yes, this one here. Yes, I have to copy this. So this was in the ebook. Get this ebook, it's for free. You'll find the link in the description. Copy. So you understand what is a trend. Yes, because a trend is important to know. So let me see. So we will do this here. So maybe it is too much. But okay, let me see if I see it's too much. I will remove it again. So okay, what is about? So let me see. I have to copy this one here, this one here. So and can explain you what makes it up a trend, uptrend and a downtrend. So we have here this one. Yes, this candle. Yes, and this is a low. Yes. So let me copy this. We have here a low, and then we have here of the low of this candle, yes, and then we have here, let me draw another arrow here, the next candle, and this is a higher low, yes. So let me draw this, let me write this, yes. So copy, higher low. So, and this is what an uptrend is about, yes. You find always higher lows, yes, higher lows. But this is not enough. This is not enough because you need also higher low, yes, because this low is higher than the previous low, okay? This is what this means, higher low, yes? For all those who don't understand this or don't know this, yes, this is important to understand what the trend is doing, yes? What kind of trend, and so you can also recognize if a trend is vanishing, yes, if a trend is disappearing, yes, or is going less strong, and this is important because you have to see, you understand where the trend is going, yes. So higher low, so and so we have another higher low, yes, here, and so we have here still an uptrend, yes, because we have another higher low here. Yes, so, yes, let me draw this in some other way. So in this manner, and this will continue as long as you have a healthy uptrend. Yes, you find always a higher low. Yes, higher low, higher low. Yes, and this is not all. Well, wait, I have to do this somewhere else. I have to move this. So let me draw this a little bit more, so I understand, make it more clear to you. So it's also better looking. So I will put this now because this is a trend now. Yes. So let me see. Higher low, higher low, higher low. So and the other part is, yes. And the other part is not only this, because this is only one part. Yes. The other part is. It makes also an uptrend, a good uptrend makes also not only higher lows, it makes also higher highs. And what are higher highs? Higher highs are, let me draw some arrows first and then I'll write this. This is a high, yes, and we have here, okay, I have to draw this in the other direction, yes, so in this direction, so one, yes, and one, another, okay, here, okay, what is this? No, line, yes, okay. So copy, paste, so it's going faster. So here, higher high, yes. We are going here, higher high, yes. And this was a retracement, like I explained in the ebook, yes. And then we have here another higher high, yes, and another higher high. This is important. If you have always higher highs, you know, and higher lows, yes, you know that you are in an uptrend, yes, and this is how I do, and everybody does recognize uptrends, yes, that is the way. So let me see, we have here the high, yes, this is a high here, because this was the first candle, so let me copy, yes, copy. And you have to also the wicks makes a part of this, yes. So we have here the high, and then we have here on the next one, because you need to start with anybody, yes. We have to start with any kind of candlestick, and from this candlestick where you start, you can go further and say, okay, this is a higher high, yes, and this is a lower high, yes. And if you have a lower high, or you have higher high and higher low, you have an uptrend. And if you, I will show you this also in the other part, because this is a crucial thing. This is really important to know, yes, because so you can identify on any kind of market if you're having an uptrend or a downtrend or a ranging market, yes, because ranging market is if the higher high, and you have to imagine that this candles here, yes, are only another one. This one of these candles can be something like this, yes. You have to understand this, that this could be a green candle here completely. So let me draw this here in this case, so, because this is what we need. So we have here, for example, this green candle is going to this level, yes. So this green candle is a representation, yes. So let me see. So this is to understand, yes. This green candle here is a representation, yes, of one of those, of all this candle here, yes, of all this candle. So right, this candle, you have seen the height. This candle is a representation of this. So this candle could be in lower time frame something like this altogether. Yes, this is what I try to explain you to make you understand. Yes, that this red candle here, for example. Yes. Okay, this is a mess here. What's going on here? So let me see. Okay, copy paste. So this red candle here, yes, represents all those here, yes, all those here. And so, because it's like fractals, yes, you know that every candle of this one, yes, can be something like this here. This candle could be also all this together, yes, because it's only compromised, yes. So okay, we have here now, let me draw some more arrows. We start, for example, with this candle, yes. So this candle is a high, yes, and this candle here, let me copy this. This candle is a high, yes, because it's above. So, and this candle here is a low, yes. So, and a downtrend is significated or identified by lower lows, yes, and lower highs. And that means this is here, let me draw another arrow here, a lower high, yes, and this is here a lower low, yes, and this is what's all about. So let me copy here this thing, so can I use them immediately for the rest. So, and when we have so we have here a lower high, yes, lower high, because this the high is lower than this, yes. And we have here a lower low, yes, a lower low, and this sounds really easy, and it is also easy, yes, if you have understood what it means, lower low and lower high. You understand also immediately what is a uptrend and what is a downtrend. And when you see some candlestick patterns, yes, or you look at the chart, you can identify only by looking for lower lows and lower highs, yes, and higher highs and lower and higher lows, if for what kind of trend you have in front of you, yes. And this is important if we are going to talk about trend channel and trend lines, yes. You have to understand this before we can talk about trend line and trend channels. So lower low. Okay, I think it's right. Let me see. No, lower, double R. So let me see. Okay, something is here not working. Okay, keep calm. Let me see. So lower. What is it? I think it's auto correction. Lower, low. Yes, so And then we copy this, yes, and I do this immediately. So I will do this here. And then we have done this. Okay, this was this part about thread identification, knowing what is lower low, higher high, lower high, higher high, and so on. Yes. Okay, let me to complete this also doing this here. Yes, copy. Okay, this was wrong. So copy. And the important thing is that we can draw then, because when we can identify lower lows and higher lows and higher highs and all this, we can draw trend lines, yes? So to understand what market will maybe doing next, yes? So, okay. This was this one. So now, what I have explained to this candle here is representing all those candles, and one of those candles, yes, could be this candle. So you can imagine what is going on. And as soon as the market is not creating more anymore lower highs and lower lows, you know there will be soon some kind of reversal. Yes. But first of all, you have to understand that could be also only a retracement, yes, because you have to understand the higher time frame, yes, because this is a higher time frame. This is 1 minute, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes. So this would be an 8 minute time frame, or maybe a 10 minute time frame, yes, and that would be the 1 minute time frame. And for this reason, I would say watch the video about retracement and reversals, yes, which I have explained. There you understand the difference. So okay, now we are going to talk about trend channel. And when I'm using arrows like this one here, yes, this shows you, and you see that are also important. So I'm gonna do now two trend channels to demonstrate it better. So we have once uptrend, yes, and so I will do this line, and I can show you then how to identify. I will remove this later, yes, but there are two parallel lines. That could be also EMAs or also Bollinger Band. Everything can this be, yes, but I will do this only now for the uptrend. So I come in here, and it's worked in this manner, that if we have, for example, we coming here in this trend channel before it was ranging or something, yes, and then we are coming into this trend channel, and now I'm gonna do here some movements, yes. And the characteristica for an uptrend is that the pullback, yes, or the retracement of this uptrend is always smaller. This one is always smaller than the movement of the direction, yes. So it could be something like this. It would be ideal, yes. But in reality, it doesn't look like this. You know that it can look everything else. It could go also outside this one, yes, a little bit, but not a lot. And then, for example, it could be going also in some kind of other manner. It's not symmetrical. So it can do in every movement, yes. And it could be also this, that this goes a little bit out, so a fake breakout or something, yes, it move going out, and then it might break out. For example, if we are going up, it will might be breaking through the lower part. But wait, I will do this also in this manner that I'm going to show you this, and then there will be also like always. So we have here the minor uptrend, yes, this is the minor uptrend. Then we have here the retracement, which is red, yes, and here red, 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 yes. So I will make it a little bit faster, and this also red, yes. And then we have here the other part. This are the movement of the market itself, yes, which are always, this is a trend. That is a trend because this is an uptrend, and so these are the trends in favor. And this is where you have to do your trades, yes. Basically, yes, in favor of this uptrend, yes. it has not to, it is not usual that it will break always down, yes? It can break at any part, yes? It's not not so that it will break out, so I will I would let it in this case, and I let it so, and then I want to do two black ones to demonstrate that we could break out at any place. It doesn't mean that we are going to break because it's a trend, and the trend can finish, and so we get some kind of reversal. And I will do this in black, for example. Yes, that you understand that we could break out here, and that is not usual that we are going to break in one direction because. But mostly it will reverse at any time, yes, but it could be also continuing. Okay, so I will remove these lines here. So it was only to make to show you this. And now I'm going to show you how it works to draw trend lines. If you are in an uptrend, you draw the lower trend line, yes, this trend line, which is of the lower part. And this is this one which you draw first, yes. And if you are and you draw them, those that you try to touch as much as possible, swing lows, yes. This is a swing low here, and you try to touch as most possible swing lows. Mostly there are already two are already enough to draw this line, yes. But you need three or more to confirm this trend, yes. So this is a swing low here, and you use two of those swing lows, yes, to identify if there is an trend coming up. And a valid trend will be at three swing lows, yes. If your trend line touches three swing lows, it's a valid one, yes, and you can do some trades based on them. You can do also trades before this, but after two, but it's better. More touches of swing lows, yes, better it is, yes, and then you can draw your trend line also if you didn't see this. You don't see these things here, yes, you don't see this. This is the future, but you can already draw this line, and you could see where there will be, might be some other swing lows, and you have to understand that there could be some kind of reversal. It doesn't mean that there will be a reversal. It could be there some kind of retracement, yes, reversal or retracement. It's the same. It's a point. It's the same, yes, because it depends always only from the. From the time frame which you are looking. So, and the same thing here with this one. After you have two of those swing lows, you can draw this line here, yes, this the ascending trend line, yes, and then you can apply this and you try to get as most as possible swing highs, yes, in this trend line to get touched with them. Yes, this is how you have to draw them. So let me get this here. So I don't need to write it again. So let me get this. And so you try to get as most as possible swing highs. Yes, and then you have your swing highs. So then you have your swing high, and then you have drawn your parallel line, yes, it's parallel line to the ascending lower trend line. So let me see, we have here, and I have to copy this, maybe. Let me see, I copy this from here, this one where I have explained already all those things. So let me see, I copy this one. We have here an ascending. This is an ascending, and this could all be a lower Bollinger band. There's one deviation Bollinger band or two deviation Bollinger band. Because at the end it's always the same, yes. So that and also EMAs, yes, could be also parallel to each other, yes. And then you have also a trend channel. So let me see. We have here ascending trend line, higher lows. Yes, right. This is right. You see here, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, and here we have higher high, higher high, higher high, higher high. Okay, so let me see, and here we have also ascending trend line, yes, but here we have higher highs. higher highs. So highs. And like I showed you in the previous video, there was a live trading explanation video of those of trades which I have done on the trend and trend line, yes, and the trend channel. Watch this video if you didn't have watched this. There I have shown you how I traded the downtrend of, and there you could see also how I have drawn this. And then obviously you can do two things, yes. You can trade the fake breakout here when it's coming back again, yes. And you can trade also the part here where let me draw this with a circle or something to demonstrate it better. So here we can trade those parts here, yes. Okay, I have to remove this. Maybe I will do this here, so a little bit smaller, yes. Okay, let's see. So. It's a center transparent. So okay, we have this. So copy paste, and yes, and you can trade this, for example, here, yes, or here, yes, at this point, you see, and you can trade them here, yes, and you can see also, and you can trade also, depending if it's an uptrend, yes, you try mostly to trade those things, for example, here in between, yes. In between and or also at the beginning, yes, in this area, yes, so because you have to imagine that you need space to the other trend line, because here could be again another reversal. That is what is this about. So let me get this all together, and yes, important is the angle of this, yes, of this trend line. If the angle is below, I would say below 30%, yes, 30 degree. It's below 30 degree, yes. Let me see. It's 30 degree. Yes. If it's 30 degree, below 30 degree, I will make it in this manner. Yes. It's a weak trend. Yes. Weak trend. Or I would say no trend, yes, no or weak trend. Weak trend. And if this is above, I would say 45%, because 45 degree, I would say it's going in a good trend, yes, good trend. A healthy trend, I would say healthy trend, yes, healthy trend. So, and if it's above 60 degree, yes, above 60 degree, then you have a strong trend, yes. So you can identify if you are in, and if you it's below 20 or 10, I would say it's, so we, wait, this is below 30, we have a weak trend, yes, and if it's below, I would say 20 or 15 degree, I would say we have ranging market. Okay, so I have explained this again, yes, with the degrees, yes. So this is the important thing, yes, and this is valid for both, yes. If it's obviously, if we are talking about a downtrend, yes, we are talking about minus 15, yes, minus 30 and minus, or let me see how it's calculated, I don't know, but you know what I mean, yes, this is that's about. So let me see if I can do this now in a fast way, so don't I consume too much time of you. Copy and paste. And then, yes, and then I move this down. Okay, so, okay, this is not bad. Yes. Oh no, where it's going? Oh no, come up. Okay, so we do this here, and how I can do this now, First of all, I have to eliminate a lot of things here. Okay, first of all, I have to turn it around. Oh no. Okay, I have understood. It will be not so easy. I will do this immediately. So I have, because I have not so many space here. So let me draw this line. So only for the explanation. And maybe while I'm doing this, there is, okay, we have here to adjust, right here, ascending channel trend line, yes, and here also, because it's a channel, yes, it's a channel trend line, but it could be everything, Bollinger Bands, yes, and EMAs, everything, yes, because at the end, that are always, and we have also here, what is important, you can trade here after, because after a breakout, yes, you can trade like always on other chart pattern, which I have explained, yes, you can trade also the pullback here, yes, like I have explained in the other parts, yes, so we get here again against the trend line, yes, and then it goes up again, yes, and so this is a pullback, and the same is valid for this one. If it's going to break out below, you can expect after this that is, it could be also some kind of pullback, and that is what you see then as some kinds of particular movements after a reversal, yes. It reverses, yes, and after this it get again higher, yes, because it's a pullback, yes, and you can wait then for the pullback to trade this pullback then, okay. So let me see, this was this one, yes, and then you can here enter into a call, for example, after the pullback. So, okay, this was this. So, okay, I have to draw some lines here. We are coming from anywhere, it doesn't matter. And the downtrend is characterized that we have always a larger down move, yes, which is greater and bigger than the down than the up move, yes, and this is why it's creating some kind of downtrend, yes, because the down move is stronger than the up move. So let me see, we are doing this in this manner. I you know, and you draw the down to the downtrend, you do you connect not the swing lows, you connect first the swing highs, yes. This is a different, yes. On the downtrend, you draw first this line here, yes, the swing highs, yes, and then you to draw the swing lows, yes. Okay, I see. I have no space here to draw this right because this was already too big. But no problem. Important is only that you understood this. You know that there will be always a pullback. I'm drawing this only to make this more clearer for you. So, and then we're gonna do here another one. So, and this was the part about the. So, then we're gonna do this here and then green. So, we have here red. Yes, and so here the downtrend is the opposite. I don't need to explain this in, to be true because it's the same stuff. Like the uptrend, if you understood the concept on the uptrend, you understand the same thing on the downtrend, yes. And we have here also the same things. It's like with all other chart patterns, yes, which I have explained: triangle, wedge, and flag, and so on. It's always the same, and if you can trade them, you can trade them all, yes. So this is how it works. So let me see, we have here also, these are also the swing lows, yes. And before you, on the uptrend, you connect two swing lows, yes. In the downtrend, you connect two swing highs, and then you try to draw the rest based on those to get the most swing lows together, yes. To connect the swing lows to draw this line here, because you connect the swing highs, yes, and then you're gonna do the trades here in uptrend, here between, yes, in a downtrend, you trade them, copy, you trade them here, yes, it's in between, far away from the reversal points, yes, where it can be reversed, yes, and you wait and you look what is going on. There will be maybe a breakout or something, yes. And so you have to be carefully. You have to understand also the candlestick patterns, yes. And here, yes. And then you draw this. And this we have here. Copy paste. So let's see. We have here the descending. Descending channel trend line with lower highs. Lower highs, yes. Descending trend line with lower highs. And copy paste. Here we have, yes, the descending channel trend line, yes, with lower lows. So, and this is how you identify this, yes, and if it's parallel and horizontal, you have a ranging market. This is valid also here for the downtrend, and so we have accomplished, yes, here we have a pullback. Okay, this is not so important, and this was the part about trend lines and trend channel and how to trade them, and if you want to see this in action, watch my latest my previous live trading video where I have done those trades based off this. Yes, you have to imagine that there will be always fake breakouts and pullbacks and so on. Yes, and also, and if you are trading some kind of Bollinger Band strategy, you are using trend channels. Yes, because Bollinger Band, you have to imagine that price goes from one Bollinger Band. Yes. This ascending channel trendline could be also a Bollinger Band, from one Bollinger Band to the other Bollinger Band, yes, and so you have the trend channel, yes, a channel trendline. The Bollinger Bands are the channel trendline. So, and this is the reason why I maybe will not complete my second edition of the ebook in this weekend, because I see that there are still missing a lot of things which I have to explain before I can publish this ebook. So, watch my latest video. Yes, watch the other videos, and as soon as I have completed this video, this ebook, I will notify you and I will tell you this. The problem is I have so many things not to explain because and that's the reason why I cannot do this at the moment, because then I should working immediately on the third edition, but I want to do a good ebook, so it will take some time more. Okay, good. I would say this was enough about this. Yes, this was a part about trend channel trading strategy and trend lines breakout. You have to see that this is always trading with the trend, is always some kind of high probability trades. Yes, because if you have the trend on your favor, that is always good, not only on Forex, also on binary option turbo trading. Yes, if you have the trend on your favor, it's one thing which is really important. You can go against the trend if you have enough evidences that there will be a reversal. Yes, then you can go also against the trend. But I prefer to go with the trend, because so you get the bigger moves, and if you get the bigger moves, you have much more probability that your trade goes in the money, yes, instead of out of the money. So, okay, I would say this was enough. I have to write here down another thing, something like downtrend, uptrend or something, yes. To make it more clear, so let me see. So how I write this here, I don't know. So let me see. Swing lows, yes, swing lows. I have to copy here also the swing highs. Okay, I will do this after this. So I would say stay safe and bye bye. Yes, if you like the video, do the like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, let me say a comment. So bye bye.